Today we want to talk a little bit about continuity of functions, what it means for a function to be continuous at a particular point. This idea of continuity is directly linked to limits in the sense that the limit gives us an idea of what we expect to be happening at a particular point, and continuity defines what that means for the function to actually be doing what we expect it to. Okay? This is an idea, continuity is an idea about niceness of the graph, okay? So in very broad general terms, it means there's no holes or gaps in the graph. If in classes where we don't discuss limits or where it's before limits, I always talk about how you can draw the graph without picking up your pencil. So it's one long continuous line, okay? In a more formal definition that I want to give to you right now, it looks like this. A function f of x is continuous at some point x equal to c if a f of c is defined. The function value actually has to be able to be defined there. B, the limit as x approaches c of f of x exists. So the two-sided limit exists, right? That's what it means when I don't have a plus or minus after that c. And c, the limit as x approaches c of f of x is actually equal to the f of c, is actually equal to the function value, okay? And then we have some language like if it's not continuous, if it doesn't meet this definition, we'll go through and we'll talk about we'll do a couple examples where I'll just check down this definition and make sure it matches all three of these criteria, okay? So, but if it's not defined or it doesn't match this criteria, so if f of x is not continuous, at x equal to c, we say f of x has a discontinuity. At x equal to c. Or it's discontinuous at x equal to c. Either one of those kind of statements works. Okay, so let's go, and I want to just do a couple examples using this definition. Example, show that f of x equals to 5x squared minus 6x plus 1 is continuous at x equal to 2. Okay, so I have those three tests that I need to do, right? So I'm just going to go down one at a time. A, is f of c defined? So in this case, f of 2, because in this particular case, c is my 2, right? So is f of 2 defined? Can I plug in 2 and get a value? So I'm just going to go ahead and plug it in. 5 times 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 1. This is just a quadratic. There's no reason why it wouldn't be defined. And I get 9. Is that what you guys get? 5 times 4 is 20. Minus 12 is 8, plus 1 is 9, okay? So yes, check, green check, yes, it meets part A condition. Okay, B. The limit, the two-sided limit as x approaches c of f of x exists. Okay? Let me check this. For this particular case, I have the limit as x approaches 2 of this function, 5x squared minus 6x plus 1. Okay, this is a polynomial, and we have that rule for polynomials that says if I want to take the two-sided limit, that's fine, just plug in, right? That's one of our rules. And when I plug in, this limit is equal to 9. Fantastic. Okay? So yes, check. It meets this second criteria. Okay? Let's go down. We're going to do part 3. C, the limit as x approaches c of f of x is equal to f of c. Okay, so in my particular case, I want to look at the limit as x approaches 2 of this 5x squared minus 6x plus 1, and is that equal to f of 2, 5, 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 1. And earlier we got 9 on this side and we got 9 on this side. That means check, yes, it matches all three of the criteria. And so as a result, because I can answer yes to all three of these, the function, I can write this conclusion statement. The function f of x, which is 5x squared minus 6x plus 1, is continuous at x is equal to 2. Okay. Let's do one more example that I just want to go ahead and go over. Example is f of x equal to 2x minus 4 over 3x minus 3 continuous at x equal to 1, question mark. Okay, so again, I have those three conditions that I have to meet. So part A, does f of c, is it defined? So let me find that for this particular function, f of 1, and I'll go ahead and try and plug in. I get negative 2 over 0. This is an undefined quantity, right? So when you're saying, I don't understand what the word defined means, this is, right? This is undefined. So this doesn't meet the criteria? No. And we can say, reach a conclusion. Well, I don't even have to do the other two tests. F of x is equal to this rational function is not continuous. At x equal to 1. It has a discontinuity at x equal to 1. Okay? Okay, I want to do one more example to make sure that we get this idea of continuity. Find A such that f of x is continuous at x is equal to 2 for this function. F of x is equal to 1 minus 2x for x less than 2, and ax squared plus 2x minus 3 for x greater than or equal to 2. Okay, so I want to go ahead and try and ensure the idea with limits And the idea in this problem is that I want both sides of the limit to, I want, let me write that. Both sides of the limit to equal the same thing. And I won't have a problem with this equaling the function value because this second piece is a polynomial, right? And I know that the limit of a polynomial function is just that actual function value. So this will be fine. So let me go ahead and I want to find the limit from the left as x approaches 2 from the left of this function, f of x, which is the same thing as finding the limit. On the left side, this is 1 minus 2x, right? That's what I have. Okay, so let me make sure. Let me go and draw maybe a graph and we'll find the limit. Okay, so this for sure is a function that gets split right here at x equal to 2. And on the left side of this, I have just a linear function, and it has slope of negative 2 up 2 over 1. So I know what that looks like. Now, if I want to take this limit, which we're kind of in the middle of doing, this is also a polynomial. I know I can just plug in the value 2 for x, and I get negative 3 as the limit. Okay? Now, I want the limit from the right to be the same. Okay, so I want the limit as x approaches 2 from the right of this right-sided function, ax squared plus 2x minus 3, to also be equal to negative 3. That's what I want the limit to be. Well, I know how to take the limit of this, again a polynomial. I just plug in 2. So I have a, I'll plug in the value 2. And I'll solve for a. So this is 4a plus 4 minus 3 equals negative 3. 4a plus 1 equals negative 3. 4a is equal to negative 4. And I think we'll get a is negative 1. So now I have this function on the right side of this to be negative x squared plus 2x minus 3. That's my second piece of this piecewise function. If we go ahead, we can graph a few points here. Let me maybe make a little xy table right over here. Let me just go ahead and plug this into my calculator. Negative x squared plus 2x minus 3. And I'm going to just get a few points. So, and I'm starting at the value of 2. And at 2, I get the value to be negative 3. At 3, negative 6. And I assume at 4 it kind of goes down from there. So over here, at 2, it's negative 3. I get this filled in. Let me draw this in a different color right here. Get this filled in. And then at 3, it goes down here to negative 6. I know it has a parabolic shape. So the graph looks something like that on this right side. But here, this idea of continuity is here. This from the left is moving towards that output value. From the right, we're moving towards the same output value. And right here, right where you're saying I'm moving towards the same output value, the actual output of the function is the same as what you were expecting it to be. There's not some huge jump or some huge hole. It's actually what you expect it to be. And this is what we talk about in terms of the niceness of the function. I'm moving along this function, and there isn't anything weird going on. It kind of continues in this very nice, smooth manner. Okay? Okay, so let me know if you have questions about that.